on one level, I'm very deeply invested in the thing as it is, like where it's coming from, and that there's an importance to that. In some way or shape or fashion, it's come into my life and now I'm building a relationship to it. To then create actual images and create a narrative out of it, that decision is rooted in, if I have a story to tell, this is a way for me to get at the density of layers that exist in that. I wanted to find a point of contact to come to not just South Africa, but the continent. When it had arisen that there would be this moment to come to Cape Town, I was extremely excited and motivated by it. The only resolution that I had was that I needed to actually make the work here, that I wouldn't be able to predetermine anything until I sort of apply my methodology to this environment. So an example would be the garments that are used throughout the exhibition. They all come from aid to trade, items that are donated from Europe and the States to countries in Africa, and they are resold wholesale to the highest bidder, basically. For me, there's a different kind of political charge just from the act of gathering clothing and knowing where they come from. I'm invested in garments more so than fabrics, because garments structurally account for the body. And my interest is in that sort of physical presence or lack thereof, because that can be reshaped and reformed. It's either combining all these materials into an object, and the object carries a level of abstraction and you're looking at the form, versus very specifically telling stories with the garments themselves because of how you're able to shape them to operate as a particular image. It's so much about the volume that it takes on, using the kind of neckline or using the shape and draping things around it to present this. And then you end up creating another narrative or another sort of life for that object, and it begins to tell a different story. Important as objects are to me, I also try to constantly push that. And sound carries a more ephemeral quality about it. There's a lot of evidence of the process in the recordings themselves. And that presents something that I think is a different kind of mark making. It's another path to developing meaning around what this is, what it really means to listen to something and to account for the experience of that process. I think presence is so vital. If I expect people to physically come to bear witness to the work and take something from it, that requires a certain amount of presence. And it's not just about like physically showing up, it's about actually bringing yourself fully into that space. There was an opportunity to actually be present in the work, present in the collection of the material, and present in the space as well. You're relying on play, intuition, improvisation, devices that you don't employ unless you put yourself in that space of vulnerability. There's a muscle in that. And I feel it's vital to try and train these muscles in a lot of ways.